Tony Porter, Cards and Dice TV, and I'm going to go over how I prepare for a series. I do a little research. What I did was I searched for the Oakland Athletics stats on Baseball Reference, and once I get there, I kind of scroll down. Now, this is a good place to look just so I can see who my closer is. Closer is Lacy, and then Jones are the two pitchers that were used the most, and then I have Hamilton, Beard, Minetto, and Lysander, and so on and so on and so forth. So anyway, that gives me some idea of what's what. But really, let me show you. I want to go to the schedule because that's going to help us the most. I'm going to look at the three-game set, and I'm going to take notes on my score sheet for the three-game set. I'll write it on one score sheet and just keep it near me as I go to the second and third games. I'm not going to write it on every score sheet. So I go to schedule and I click on that. It's going to bring me to the schedule. Now the series is played May 17th. So I'm going to scroll down to May 17th. I passed that. I went pretty fast there. Okay. April. Let's go to May. All right, May 17th. There it is. Toronto. May 16th, 17th, and 18th. Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. So let me start taking notes of what's what. Click on the box score for the first game and see what information that'll give me. Excuse me. Now I'm going to, I take a look at the score, was 1-0. I'm going to just make note of relievers and pinch hitters. There's none for the A's, one pinch hitter for the Blue Jays. So this game doesn't help me too much, but I know I have at least one pinch hitter for the Blue Jays. I want to get three or four pinch hitters and three or four relievers just in case I need them. So let's go to game two, see what happens. All right, game two. In the A's, we're going to get a pinch runner. I'm going to jot that down. Excuse me. And Newman at first base comes in to replace Revering. Newman is a righty, Revering's a lefty. So basically, that's kind of the platoon switch that they do. And same here. Whenever a lefty comes in, they're going to bring in Klutz. So these two guys can pinch hit, and then they can stay in. Cozy is going to be used as a pinch hitter, and McKay the same. He's a switch hitter, whereas Picciolo is just a righty. So I'm going to write down all these names of those players, and then I'm going to scroll down to the Blue Jays. And I got a pinch runner, Cannon. I got a pinch hitter, Willie Upshaw, Barry Bonnell, and Ernie Witt. So these are all my pinch hitters, and of course, they play those positions. For relievers, I got one guy, Joey McLaughlin. So I'm going to write all that down and go to game three. All right, game three. This is a blowout. So, and I'm going to tell you right now that they probably used some relievers, and they're not their main guys. So let's see who they do use. They use Hamilton, Souza, and Lysander. Definitely not their main guys, so I know that I'll have those in case there's a blowout. But there's nothing here going on in Toronto. I don't have enough relievers for the Blue Jays, so I'm going to have to go one more game with the Blue Jays forward. Sometimes I go one back. Try to stay as close to the three-game series as I can because I want those guys on the roster. If you go too far away, there could have been injuries or guys sent down or guys released, trades and all that. So I want to stay as close to that series as possible. So that's Boston, but we're looking at the Blue Jays. Well, this game doesn't help because, again, there's no substitutions. Remember, this is 1980. So let's see one more game forward. And it looks like, this will give us some more. Ainge, Danny Ainge, the basketball player. He was with the Blue Jays for a couple of seasons. Davis and Bonnell. Okay, we know we have those. We have enough pinch hitters for the Blue Jays. What we need are some relievers. More Garvin and Buskey. And then what I would do is I would, I know that Garvin is a reliever. All these guys can serve as closers as well, according to the data that I already looked at on Baseball Reference. So, but you can also look and see on their card if it has some stats and it shows a few saves. Well, you can always bring them in. I think Buskey, I think Garvin had the most saves, like 6 or 7. Moore had 4 or 5 and that sort of thing. So, and that's it. So I would write all that information down, and I'm ready to play my series. And I, like I said, I use actual lineups, but I do make the changes as close to reality as possible, within reason. Like if it's a blowout, I'm not going to use my closer. You know, that's how usually I play it. So anyway, this is Cards and Dice TV, Tony Porter. I hope that helps. Thanks.